Sheep and goats like these grazing in the fields of Kotido district in Karamoja sub-region are a common sight as one drives through the expansive fields. The animals have to struggle to get what to eat due to lack of adequate pasture in the semi-arid area. But recent rains in the area have aided the growth of some pasture, and animals now have some relief.
But it is not that the pastures are not of high quality. The pastures are of good quality, actually. Sometimes even better quality than some of those southern areas. But the problem is the rain is not enough. And the pastures are there for only a shorter time. But otherwise, they are very nutritious.
The rains came after a long dry spell, which left the ground bare and many seasonal streams and rivers dry. Because of the current rains, valley dams like this in Natafir, constructed by Oxfam with the help of the community, are now filled up. Now the community and their animals are relying on this dam for water, even when it's not safe for drinking and is miles away from most homes.
These ones have to move very far to get the grass. As you drove from Kotido up this place here, which is about 20 kilometers away, you saw there was not much grass on the way. And that means the animals must move a little bit far to get this grass. So most of the energy is burned in the process of moving up and down. Otherwise, they are healthy.
But to promote a safer option for the people here, a rock catchment dam was constructed to trap the water above this dam. During the rainy season, plenty of water moves down these rocks, and it is at this point that it is collected where it is filtered before it is transported down into the underground tanks. All the water is diverted to an underground tank dug next to the dam, from where it is treated to remove the debris that comes with water flowing on the rocks. The tanks have sealed and filtration chambers.
So we designed a way in such a way that we installed a borehole, a U2 hand pump, on top of those tanks, and equipped with a cylinder. It is able to draw water from those tanks.
However, due to water scarcity in the area and the huge population, the borehole has dried up and doesn't even have a drop of water.
We have to share with animals because it is the only source. We do not have any other option. And when they both dry up, we travel more miles to find water.
The challenge is that the system can only be effective during the rainy season and is not applicable in the dry season.
In the design process, it was supposed to be used in the 4 months of the dry season, when there's totally no other alternative for water for consumption. But because of that, the communities end up using the water before the dry season. That's why sometimes it gets finished up.
But various natural water resources such as ponds and traditional river wells remain in use. These sources are unsafe though, and the water levels very low, meaning they are not sustainable over the dry season. Agriculture activity has come down in the area because most crops dry up before they mature. As such, farmers have incurred losses. They have resorted to pastoralism as a way of life. Karamoja has for long been a predominantly dry area, but as the effects of climate change take a toll on the area, the dry spells could become even longer. But, on the other hand, unprecedented heavy rains could fall unexpectedly, leaving floods that can cause considerable devastation. Krikadoda, NTV, Ecotalk.